Hi, welcome to Bible Buddy. Today is day number 30. We will be reading Exodus 20 and 21. And so let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for giving me eternal life. Holy Spirit, come and reveal more of Jesus to me day by day. Come now and enlighten me as I read these sacred scriptures. Amen. I will be reading from the New Internet, the New Living Translation, and let's open up the Bible to Exodus 20. Then God gave the people all these instructions. I am the Lord your God, who rescued you from the land of Egypt, the place of your slavery. You must not have any other God but me. You must not make for yourself an idol of any kind or an image of anything in the heavens or on the earth or in the sea. You must not bow down to them or worship them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God who will not tolerate your affection for any other gods. I lay the sins of the parents upon their children. The entire family is affected. Even children in the third and fourth generations of those who reject me. But I lavish unfailing love for 1,000 generations on those who love me and obey my commands. You must not misuse the name of the Lord your God. The Lord will not let you go unpunished if you misuse his name. Remember to observe the Sabbath day by keeping it holy. You have 6 days each week for your ordinary work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath day of rest dedicated to the Lord your God. On that day, no one in your household may do any work. This includes your son, you, your sons, your daughters, your male and female servants, your livestock, and any foreigners living among you. For in 6 days the Lord made the heavens, the earth, the sea, and everything in them. But on the seventh day he rested. That is why the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and set it apart as holy. Honor your father and mother. Then you will live a long and full life in the land of the Lord your God is giving you. You must not murder. You must not commit adultery. You must not steal. You must not testify falsely against your neighbor. You must not covet your neighbor's house. You must not covet your neighbor's wife, male and female servant, ox or donkey, or anything else that belongs to your neighbor. When the people heard the thunder and the loud blast from the ram's horn, and when they saw the flashes of lightning and the smoke billowing from the mountain, they stood at a distance, trembling with fear, and they said to Moses, "You speak to us, and we will listen, but don't let God speak directly to us, or we will die." "Don't be afraid," Moses answered them, "for God has come in this way to test you, and so that your fear of him will keep you away from sinning." And for the people stood in the distance, Moses approached the dark cloud where God was. As the Lord said to Moses, "Say this to the people of Israel, you saw for yourselves that I spoke to you from heaven. Remember, you must not make any idols of silver or gold to rival me. Build for me an altar made of earth and offer your sacrifices to me, your burnt offerings and your peace offerings, your sheep and your goats and your cattle. Build an altar wherever I cause my name to be remembered, and I will come to you and bless you. If you use stones to build my altar, use only natural, uncut stones. Do not shape the stones with a tool, for that would make the altar unfit for holy use. Do not approach my altar by going up steps. If you do, someone might look up under your clothing and see your nakedness. These are the regulations you must present to Israel. If you buy a Hebrew slave, he may serve you for no more than 6 years. Set him free for the seventh year, and he will owe you nothing for his freedom. If he was single when he became your slave, he shall leave single. But if he was married before he became a slave, then his wife must be freed with him. If his master gave him a wife while he was a slave, and he had sons or daughters, then only the man will be free in the seventh year, but his wife and children still belong to his master. But the slave may declare, "I love my master, my wife, and my children. I don't want to go free." If he does this, his master will present him before God. Then his master must take him to the door or doorpost to publicly pierce his ear with an awl. After that, the slave will serve his master for life. When a man sells his daughter as a slave, she will not be freed at the end of the 6 years as the men are. If she does not satisfy her owner, he must allow her to be bought back again. If he is not allowed to sell her to foreigners, since he is the one who broke the contract with her. But if the slave's owner arranges for her to marry his son, then he may no longer treat her as a slave, but as a daughter. If a man who has married a slave takes on another wife himself, he must not neglect the rights of the first wife to food, clothing, and sexual intimacy. You guys get the point. Intimacy. If he fails in any of these obligations, she may leave as a free woman without making any payment. Anyone who assaults and kills another person must be put to death. But if it was simply an accident permitted by God, I will appoint a place of refuge where a slayer can run for safety. However, if someone deliberately kills another person, then the slayer must be dragged even from my altar and be put to death. Anyone who strikes a father or mother must be put to death. Kidnappers must be put to death, whether they are caught in possession of their victims or have already sold them as slaves. Anyone who dishonors father or mother must be put to death. Now suppose two men quarrel and one hits the other with a stone or fist, and the injured person does not die but is confined to bed. If he is later able to walk outside again, even with a crutch, the assailant will not be punished but must compensate his victim for lost wages and provide for his full recovery. If a man beats his male or female slave with a club and the slave dies as a result, the owner must be punished. If the slave recovers within a day or two, then the owner shall not be punished, since the slave is his property. Now suppose two men are fighting and in the process they accidentally strike a pregnant woman, so she gives birth prematurely. If no further injury results, the man who struck the woman must pay the amount of compensation to the woman's husband demands and the judges approve. But if there is further injury, the punishment must match the injury. A life for a life, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, and a hand for a hand, a foot for a foot, a burn for a burn, a wound for a wound, and a bruise for a bruise. If a man hits his male or female slave in the eye and the eye is blinded, he must let the slave go free to compensate for the eye. And if a man knocks out a tooth of his male or female slave, he must let the slave go free to compensate for the tooth. If an ox gores a man or a woman to death, the ox must be stoned and its flesh may not be eaten. In such a case, however, the owner will not be held liable. But suppose the ox had a reputation for goring and the owner had been informed but failed to keep it under control. If the ox then kills someone, it must be stoned and the owner must also be put to death. However, the dead person's relatives may accept payment to compensate for the loss of the life. The owner of the ox may redeem his life by paying whatever is demanded. The same regulation applies if the ox gores a boy or a girl. If the ox gores a slave, either male or female, the animal's owner must pay the slave's owner 30 silver coins, and the ox must be stoned. Suppose someone digs or uncovers a pit and fails to cover it, and then an ox or a donkey falls into it. The owner of the pit must pay full compensation to the owner of the animal, but then he gets to keep the dead animal. If someone's ox injures a neighbor's ox and the injured ox dies, then the two owners must sell the live ox and divide the price equally between them. They must also divide the dead animal. But if the ox had a reputation for goring, yet its owner failed to keep it under control, he must pay full compensation, a live ox for a dead one. but he may keep the dead ox. This is very interesting, especially for me, because in real life, I work in a personal injury law firm. So this is very interesting. I will see you tomorrow for day number 31. Have a blessed day, everyone.